Yo, what is up, guys? I have not done a dread tutorial in a while, it seems like. Probably because I don't have any dreadlocks anymore, but I actually did a video a long time ago on how I gave Diddy, you guys know Activerse, go check them out. Today's video is gonna be about how to get dreadlocks or start your dreadlocks with a towel. It's very simple. It's the same as a dread sponge. We got about 2-3 inches of hair right here. We're gonna be giving us some starter locks with just a towel. I don't think I've seen any videos on this. There's not many out there, but it's quick, easy, and anybody can do it. This is actually how I started my dreadlocks. But today on the show, we have our very own Taj Coney. Make sure you go follow him on Instagram. Probably takes all my photos that you see on my Instagram. So go give him a follow. Now let's get this tutorial started right about now. But you guys, you can pick up all hair products or dreadlock products on greatlocks.com. Today we're only using a towel. This isn't going to be on greatlocks.com, but if you have dreadlocks, want to get dreadlocks, you can go there and basically purchase anything you need or watch videos on how to actually maintain or start your dreadlocks. So let's get started. The only thing you're going to need in today's video is a towel. Typically you want to use a darker towel. Don't use a white one, because what's going to happen is if you're using a white towel, you're gonna get white particles in your hair. You ever see people with dreadlocks and they just got like white fuzzies? It's probably because they don't know what they're doing. But second, it could be that they're using a white towel. What I like to do is I fold the towel once, hamburger style, two, hot dog style, and then literally all you're gonna do is go in a clockwise or counterclockwise motion, but don't switch the rotation once you start. So let's go ahead and start. We're gonna go clockwise. And you'll see how this starts to form, even though I'm using a towel. A lot of people think they have to go to the barbershop and use the sponge, or spend money on Amazon, get the sponge. Although you can go to greatlocks.com and pick up a dread sponge if you don't wanna look silly using a towel. But hey, it's free 99. But literally, it's the same thing. What I like to do is stay at the surface of the hair. Don't push too hard, because what's gonna happen is it's just not gonna look right and the sections aren't gonna be made perfect. So you want to kind of, you know, do, you know, shorter circles for skinnier dreadlocks, bigger circles for bigger dreadlocks. We're gonna go for some skinny dreadlocks, so I'm doing skinny circles. But what you can see is that you can already see some separation, and you'll see the coils, and what you can tell is that your hair isn't as like circular. They'll start to become more, I would say, nappy look, like a nappy look, which that looks cool as well if you were to just go with that. But this is also a way to start out dreadlocks. A lot of people call them semi-freeform dreadlocks. I just call them sponge or towel rub dreadlocks, because I don't think there's a thing called semi-freeform, because freeform is just strictly doing nothing but washing your hair and allowing it to dry and allowing it to lock up on its own. Now, I can say that the best hair type to have while doing this method is a more coarse curl pattern. Taj has probably about a 4B hair type, and this is perfect for this method. And I have about a 3C hair type, and it was perfect for me as well, because I mean, my dreadlocks started instantly. What I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna focus on this right side, and then I'll show you guys the difference between both sides. Thank you. Yeah, because I went to the barber shop. I went to quick cuts or whatever they're called, sports cuts.
Great
clips. Over in Kansas City, there was one called sports cuts or sports clips or something like that. I was like, man, she didn't know how to do a fade. Oh, I said, God. Can you give me a high top fade? She said, I can't do that on your hair. I said, what? You can do a high top fade on anybody.
Yeah.
Tried getting dreadlocks with the towel, and then I was like, oh shoot, this stuff works.
Yeah.
So then I just kept on doing it, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna go ahead and get dreads. Yeah, because at first I didn't even plan on it. I mean, I always wanted them, but then, like, I didn't really decide to get them until I tried it out. So we're starting to get a bunch of big separation up here. You can start to feel the coils thicken up, and that's a good thing, because what's gonna happen is, like, there's still a frizz inside of here that is eventually gonna lock up. But what happens when you keep on doing this, it gets more separation and allows it to go all the way down to the root if you were to keep going. I remember I got my dreadlocks, like I started them with the towel, and then I had them for like 2 weeks, and then I was like, all right, I'm gonna wash my hair. And then I washed it, and then all of them came out.
Yeah.
I was mad, man. All right, so I did this half of the head. It's probably literally only been like, well, 9 to 10 minutes. And you can already like feel all the separation. It doesn't show as much on camera. I'll show you guys some B-roll of what it looks like as far as like both sides. You can see a huge difference. I touched the side a little bit at the beginning, but this side is the side that I focused on. One thing that you'll notice is that you can feel all of the separations, and that's what you mostly want to feel for, because you're not really going to notice it at first, but if you keep doing this every single day, your hair is going to get a bunch of separation. Like I said, this is how I started my dreadlocks, and it literally works if you have the right hair type and the right hair length. You want about 2 to 3 inches of hair length, and you want about a, I would say maybe 3A all the way to 4C hair type, and should be straight. And just take about, you know, 30 minutes, because I only did this for 10 minutes, but 30 minutes to, you know, use the towel, or if you choose a sponge, use a sponge for about 30 minutes a day. It should be straight, and then you can choose any other maintenance method afterward. I'm gonna show you guys some close-ups so you can see what this looks like. Okay, so you guys can see the separations on this side of the head. You can see, as I move my hand in here, you can see the separations go deeper, and that's what you want it to look like, because you can see that like there's some dark deep spots, and all it takes is just doing some more sponge rub. And I know you guys are seeing some light spots, but Taj actually used to have bleach blonde hair, so that's why those spots are there. It's not from the towel. And yeah, just make sure, I would prefer using a black towel, because then you won't have any you know, light colors in there. But I'm gonna show you guys the opposite side, show you the difference of, you could see how all this is still connected. You can't really see any separation or anything like that right here. And you can just see, as you come over to this side, you can see all of that separation. So you can see a huge difference. I'm gonna do this for a little bit longer, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like at the end. Yeah, I might restart my dreads one of these days. I'm not sure how soon though. Yeah. I might do freeform, like have them look all crazy and stuff. Like super thick or something, that'd be dope. All right, y'all, it's pretty simple. It's pretty self-explanatory on how to do this. All you need is a towel and literally your hand. If you don't have a hand, you know what? Have your friend's hand. That's what I'm here for, Taj, you know what I'm saying? I got him with, you know, hooking him up with some of these little coils and starter locks, you know what I'm saying? Like these, if you leave them in, if you take your time, do this about 30 minutes a day, like I said, you're gonna have some really good looking dreadlocks. If you guys like the way my dreadlocks look, then you'll definitely like this method on how to get them. So all you do, like I said, break down everything, get yourself a towel, you know, fold it twice, do it in a 360 motion, either counterclockwise or clockwise. Make sure you follow that motion the entire way. And then you get some good looking starter locks, or you could call them semi-freeform locks, or just a nappy look. A huge tip that I'll tell you guys is, when you're starting out, start out very light. Allow the coils to start from the tip and then go all the way down to the root. So start out very light, and then as you start to see the coils form, you want to start putting more pressure on so that you can work your way down to the root. As long as you follow that tip, you should be straight and they'll turn out looking good. But that's today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. I'm gonna show you guys a quick 360 on B-roll right here. And hopefully you enjoyed today's video. Like I said, if you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to go check out greatlocks.com. I'm gonna leave a link to the dread sponge down below in the description box. Other than that, I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully you guys do have an amazing day. Matter of fact, have a great day. Peace out and God bless.